Hello viewer, it's my pleasure to welcome you all for learning the civil engineering concepts. Hello viewers, in this video I will discuss about the bolted connections. The bolts are generally designated by its grade. If the grade is 4.6, means that 4 indicates 4 times 100 will give the ultimate tensile strength. Okay? Then that 0.6 indicates 0.6 times 400 will give the yield strength of the bolt. The structural steel sections used in India are made up of the grade of Fe410. That indicates the ultimate tensile strength of the steel is 410 MPa. Yield strength of the steel is 250 MPa. All the sections are made up of mild steel. Bolts are generally classified into 3 types. First one is black bolt. Why it is black bolts? The color itself almost black in color. It is having either square headed or hexagonal headed. It is usually of 4.6 in grade. Then what is meant by snug tight condition? The maximum tightness that can be achieved by a person by giving their full effort using the standard spanner is called snug tight condition. The black bolts are ductile in nature because it is made up of mild steel. They are cheaply available in the market. It can be only used for static loads. The second type is turned or fitted bolts that are available in the grades from 4.6 to 8.8. They are having close tolerance with the drilled holes. Generally, these turned or fitted bolts are used in automobile industry. If you see in the bike, scooter, in that bolts used will have a grades. The next one is HSFG bolts that can be expanded as high strength friction grip bolts. These bolts are available from the grade of 8.8 to 10.9. These are less ductile in nature because if the carbon content increase in the steel means strength will be increased, ductility will be reduced. This can be used under dynamic and fatigue loads. If you want to design a structure to withstand against the wind and seismic loads means you have to use the high strength friction grip bolts. This figure shows the bolt assembly consists of the bolt and nut and washer. Bolt have a head, sung or body of this bolt. This one is threaded portion. Sometimes bolts may be fully threaded. Sometimes it is partly threaded. Then this is the washer. This is the nut. Then this indicates the length of the bolt. This indicates the length of the bolt. Then what is meant by grip? That is the total thickness of the plates which are connected by using the bolts are called the grip length. This is quiz time. The question for you is, the grip length is always dash length of the bolt. You have 4 choices. Press pause button and go through the answers. Note your answers. Your time starts now. Option B is the correct answer. Based on the load transfer mechanism, bolts can be classified into 2 types. One is bearing type bolt, another one is friction type bolt. This shows the picture of the bearing type bolt connections. Suppose I am considering the 2 plates which are connected by using this bolt. Okay. The bearing type bolt will allow small slip. How it allows a small slip? You can carefully see the figure. Due to this force, this direction, the plates touches at the bottom of the bolt. Here, the force acting in this direction make the plate touch with the bolt. So that means it allows a small slip. We know that diameter of the hole is always little greater than the diameter of the bolt. Okay? In this, the load will be transferred by bearing. Load will be transferred by bearing. Coming to the HSFG type bolt. that are high strength friction grip balls. Name itself, it is a friction grip balls. Therefore, the force will be transferred by friction. What is the nature of the friction? Friction, it always acts opposite to the direction of motion. Suppose if this plate is moves in this direction, friction will act in the opposite direction. This plate moves in this direction, friction will act in the opposite directions. Okay. How we can achieve the friction between the pole? We have to give the full tightness to the nut. Here, we will, the bearing type bolt, we will use only snug tight conditions. Here, you have to give the tightness above the snug tight conditions using the torsion twisting machine. And what will happen? Top, we have a head, bottom, we have a bolt. We are giving the full tightness. We are compressing the plates. Then what will happen? The plates will give resistance. The plate will give resistance. That will give resistance. Due to that resistance, bolt will experience which force? Bolt will experience tensile force. This tension is occurs in the bolt before we are applying the load to the bolt. That's why it is called as pretension. That's why it is called as pretension. That can be calculated by using the formula available in IS 800. So, the bolt is subjected to pretension before applying the load. That means we should not use that normal grade of bolt. This type of bolts need a high strength. So, that's why we are going for the high strength like this 8.8. 10.9. You will see the different types of failure modes of the bolted connections. Suppose I want to design a bolted connection. What is my output? I have to tell how many number of bolts has to be provided. What is the diameter of the bolt? What is the grade of bolt? What is the pitch used? The main item is I have to tell the number of bolts. How we can calculate the number of bolts? We will calculate the total load. For the problem, they will give the total load. We have to calculate the strength of the one bolt. Total load divided by strength of the one bolt will give the number of bolts. That's all. Design is simple. So, our ultimate aim is to find the strength of the one bolt. How we can find the strength of the one bolt? Before finding the strength of the one bolt, we have to consider the possible failure modes of the bolted connections. The possible failure modes are here. So one is single shear failure. The shear stresses are generated when the plates are slipped due to applied forces. Let us consider two plates which are joined by using a bolt. Suppose if I apply a tensile force, what will happen? Bolt will cut at the interface of the plate. That interface is the having that interface have shear plane. If the two plates are slipped due to applied forces, means we will have only one shear plane. We consider here three plates. See, this top two plates are moving in one direction, the middle plate moving in the other direction, means we have the two interfaces. So the bolt will cut at two locations. Because it is having two shear planes. So that is called double shear failure. Next, we will consider the bearing failure. In the bearing failure, see here, two plates are joined by using a plate. Due to the slip, and the plate will bear with the bolt, and it will, what happened? Bolt diameter is got reduced. The crushing of the bolt due to plate is called the bearing failure of the bolt. If the bolt was crushed due to the plate, means it is called the bearing failure of the bolt. If the plate is crushed due to the bolt, means that is called bearing failure of the plate. When the bolt is made up of weaker material, The plate is made up of stronger material, means bolt weld failed in bearing. Suppose plate is a weaker material, means bolt having stronger material, means plate will fails in bearing. The next mode is the shear out failure. If you didn't provide the proper edge distance and all, means the edge of the plate will shear out. In some cases, the tearing of the failures will happen. Okay? That this is the tearing failure of the plate. This is the bearing failure of the plate. Okay? Some cases, cleavage failure will occur. In some cases, cleavage as well as the tension. In this line, we have a tensile force. Okay? These are the possible failure modes of the bolted connections. First, we have to calculate the load required for the each failure. Shear failure of the bolt, bearing failure of the bolt, bearing failure of the plate, shear out failure of the plate, tearing failure of the plate, cleavage failure. For each case, we have to calculate the load. Among these loads, whichever is the lower, that will be the strength of the bolt. That will be your strength of the bolt. Total load will divided by strength of the one bolt will give the number of bolts.